Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. In this Microsoft PowerPoint animation tutorial, we are going to make seesaw animation using simple shapes, which is inspired by MoveShapes After Effects tutorial. After Effects support keyframes for motion path, which is unfortunately not available in PowerPoint, and you can only adjust the start and end smoothness timings. Besides that, you cannot control how fast or slow a motion path should be. Let's begin with selection pane from the Home tab and have a look at the objects used in this presentation. Here we have a rectangle, a triangle, two seesaw shapes, and an oval shape as a base. The rectangle and triangle have been filled with a picture of stock images, and the seesaw and base have been filled with patterns. Before we look into the animation effects, first look at the beginning positions of all these objects. The animation begins from the rectangle falling from the top, and the triangle shape is already on top of the seesaw one shape at 345 degrees rotation. The seesaw one shape has also been rotated at 345 degrees angle. We have two seesaw shapes here, but during the slideshow, we only see one at a time. Now, let's look at the animation effects, and for that, we will open the animation pane from the Animations tab. The first effect we have here is the motion path applied to the rectangle, and you can see that the end point of this motion path is right on top of the seesaw 2 shape. The duration of this effect is 2 seconds with a start smoothness of 2 seconds. We are also rotating this rectangle at 195 degrees clockwise using the spin effect, which also has the same start smoothness of 2 seconds. So, if we delete all the other effects for a while and see the slideshow, then you can see that the rectangle falls from top to bottom and stops right on top of the seesaw 2 shape at 195 degrees angle. We want the seesaw 1 shape to rotate when the rectangle touches it, and so for that, we also apply the spin effect to it. Note down that we are using a delay timing of 1.60 seconds, and that is when the rectangle touches the seesaw. And the duration of this effect is just 0.40 seconds. We are rotating the seesaw 1 at 30 degrees clockwise. So, if we see the slideshow having only these three effects, then you can see how both the shapes move and rotate together. At this point, we are hiding the seesaw 1 shape using the disappear effect at a delay timing of 2 seconds, and right at this movement, we are showing the seesaw 2 shape using the appear effect. During the slideshow, the viewer will not notice that there were two seesaw shapes, one is hiding, and another is showing. Then we want the triangle shape to move upwards right when the rectangle touches the seesaw. You can note the delay timing is 1.60 seconds, and that is when the rectangle touches the seesaw. We are also taking the help of guides to align and match the start and end positions of the motion paths, which you can turn on from the View tab. If needed, then you can also add more horizontal or vertical guides by right-clicking on any one of the guides. The time duration of motion path applied to the triangle is 1 second, but as we are using auto reverse, so a complete up and down loop will be of 2 seconds. We are rotating the triangle at 360 degrees as we want the triangle to stop at the same angle, and the time duration is also 2 seconds for this effect. Finally, to complete one loop of this animation, we are again spinning the seesaw 2 shape to 30 degrees clockwise, and then applying the up motion path to the rectangle along with the spin effect at 195 degrees counterclockwise rotation, which places the rectangle right at the same position from where the animation begins. As we now have one complete loop of the seesaw animation, Now you can make more duplicates of this slide and apply a transition timing to automatically move forward the next slides and make as many loops as possible you want. According to the shape objects, animation effects, time duration, and delay timings we used over the first slide, we can also use the loop continuously until the escape key is pressed option from the slideshow tab instead of making duplicate slides to create further loops. So, I hope you will find this video interesting and informative. Let us know your feedback by liking, sharing, and commenting. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching and have a great day.